Hi, welcome back to Wheeled Mobile Robot. This is again a supplement to the you can say NPTEL course. So I got actually like some you can say concerns or queries have come. So how can I actually like draw probably you call a triangular shape vehicle, or how I can actually like follow a trajectory which is in the triangular shape. So for example, for a triangular shape trajectory, we know already. So we have seen like n number of via points. Even the via point can actually like have a non-zero initial or like non-zero velocity, in the sense that entire triangular trajectory can be considered as a single trajectory. Then it may not look like a you can say triangular shape. But if we want to go a triangular where the initial and final velocity can be considered as zero, then it will take three segment, and then each segment would be start from zero initial velocity and go to final again zero velocity. So it will go. So in that sense, whether it's a right angle triangle or equilateral triangle or whatever kind of triangle you want to draw, this all can be seen there. So that's what the idea. And similarly, some people asked, can you show like you have always shown something like a rectangular shaped vehicle? Can I actually like draw probably a triangular shape for a simple example? There is a three omni-wheel drive which usually come as a, you can say, a triangular shape, that to like equilateral triangle. Can you draw that and show some kind of simulations? So in order to make these two, you can say, complement constraint to be satisfied, so I have just added this particular short video. So where we would be taking a triangular shape omnidirectional wheel, three omnidirectional wheel mobile robot, and that robot would be following probably a triangular shape trajectory, that too in dynamic level. And some other questions also came, so how to change the parameter in the model and how to actually like play this. So I just want to do that here in detail. Okay, so in that sense, we can actually like see like what we are going to do. So some of the MATLAB simulation related to omnidirectional mobile robot system. That is what we are actually like trying to do. So this is the three Omni wheels mobile base. So you can see like it is look like a triangular shape. Can we actually like do the same thing in probably MATLAB patch, or you can say a field patch, and then try to make animation? Yes, we can do it. So what we can do, we can mark a triangle. Okay, then you can actually like mark this, you can say again a rectangular as the wheel as the rectangle, and the roller also like small rectangular. So since it is actually like dual wheel, but I assume that it's a single wheel. So in that sense, you can see like this is a triangular shape mobile base, and these are the three omni wheel. So the gray color is actually like wheel hub, and the black color is the roller, which is opposite direction rotation. And this is the body frame. So in order to show this, so what I used to do is actually like, so we will mark like these two points. So this indicates actually like x direction of the vehicle. That's all. So now we'll go to the MATLAB and then see like how this can be done. So for that, I've just taken MATLAB simulation, that to like kinematic control model. So this is the, you can say Newton Euler, sorry, in this case, it is actually like Euler integration parameter. This is a DT, or you can say delta T, which is the step size. And this is the what you call the total simulation time. And this is the time span. And this is a very simple code. And here I have assumed that the 51, 52, 53 are the three angle where the center from the base, how much angle oriented of three wheels. So in that case, if I take this is 30, then this is 30 plus 120, and this is, you can say 120 plus this. Okay, so this will give, and I just want to plot you can say a triangle, so I just make it this. So now coming to the wheel radius, so here I've assumed that the wheel radius is actually like 10 centimeters. It's very bigger wheel, so in this is 20 centimeter as the dia, and you can say the wheel centered to, you can say, vehicle frame. I assume that uniform, and that is having 0.5 meter. And the half of the width of the wheel, I assume that 0.025, in the sense the width of the wheel is actually like 5 centimeter. I assume it is very big, okay, which is not really usually obtainable, but the width is actually like 5 centimeter is more or less obtainable, and 10 centimeter, you can say radius is really actually like tricky, because we used to get 7.5 centimeter and 4.5 centimeter width are actually very common. And further, we can actually go with a circular trajectory or any other trajectory. So that is immaterial for us. So this is actually like simple kinematic control. And this is the, you can say, omnidirectional, you can say, wheel configuration matrix inverse. And this is the wheel configuration matrix. And we can find the individual velocity command. So the velocity command is obtained based on simple proportional control. Then we can actually like get the individual wheel velocities. So then we can actually like impose some constraint. Here I have put the constraint is, so the wheel velocity is obtained in a first order model where the delay, or you can say the time constant, is 1 second and the efficiency is 90%. So in the sense, 0.9 minus exponential of minus t of i. So in the sense, this way it will work. So now coming to the vehicle, how we have modeled it. So we assume that the vehicle is actually like a rectangular shape usually, but here it is a triangular shape. So for that, we are taking this where theta is actually like, if you look at it, it 51 to 51, where it goes pi to 53. So, and we assume that it is L is the uniform length. So then you can see, like, if I take L into cos, this you can say cos theta 1. So this will give 4 points, and this also will give 4 points. This is related to x of coordinate of that point, and this is y coordinate. So now if I actually like cover that, so I'll actually like get it. So what that means, so if I actually like start, this is the point, and this is the point, and this is the point, so it will actually like make it a cover. So this is what we can actually like do it. So that is what we are also like doing it here. So in that sense, you can see like that. Then the wheel, I'm actually like assuming that the wheel radius, you know, so from the center, it is actually like both side, the length would be equal to radius, but you can say opposite direction minus a and plus a. And similarly, the off width is actually like w here. So we can actually like make a rectangle again. So I'll just make it that rectangle. So this is the way I assume this is. So this is, you can see this is, so a omega, this is minus a, this is, okay, so this is a comma omega, and this is minus a comma, right? So now this is what we have drawn, and again it is coming, so it is actually like 5 points, right? Similarly, the roller, it is actually like I assumed here. So the roller is actually like just opposite direction. So I assume that the roller length is actually like a by 3. So in a sense, 1/3 of the radius would be the roller thickness. Okay, the width is actually like what you can call that way, and the radius of the roller is actually like equal to w. Okay, so that way we can assume. So that way we can actually take it. So, and we have 3 wheels. So each wheel we have actually like taken. So the rotation is we consider, and then this is actually like on top of the base. So then the base also rotating. Okay, so this is the way we can actually like make it. Okay, so now first I will show here, then you can actually like take it. So here the desired is actually like moving, x desired moving is actually like a 0.05, and y desired is actually like going a 0.05 as the rate of the thing, in the sense 0.05 meter per second, x and y is actually like moving. This is the vehicle will go lateral direction with a 45 degree, right? So that we can actually like check. I will just show the simulation. So then you can actually like find it. So now you can see that the vehicle going, and you closely note. So the blue is actually like wheel hub, and the green patch is the roller. So it is look like the wheel is rotating, right? So now this is actually like with the zero orientation. So now even we want to make this is rotating 45 degree. So that also we can do it. So for example, I'm saying that this is actually like, because it is moving in a 45 degree line. So I'm just assuming that it is supposed to go. So it is actually like, okay, the side desired I have assumed as zero in the next slide. So that I'll just correct it. So this we make it zero. So now I'll just run it. So now you can see like it is actually like trying to rotate and then doing. So now you can see this wheel doesn't have any roll that you can clearly see. So it is not rotating, but these two are actually like rotating. You can see the green patch is moving, right? So that way we can actually like see if you go to omega one would be zero, and probably initial phase it would be, after that it becomes zero, and omega two, omega three will go. just to check that. So I'm just going to that. So I'll just try to show that into MATLAB window. So I'm just trying to subplot T comma omega. Okay. So now you can see like there are three. So the omega one actually like becomes zero, and these two are actually like trying to go in the 45-degree line. And you know, like these two are supposed to be equal and opposite in order to go in the forward direction, right? So this is one thing. So now there may be a question. So there may be a question for you. It will come. So this you consider 30-degree. Can you like 0-degree? Can you just consider some other thing? For example, I'm taking 60-degree. Okay. So now still you can actually like see. So now you can see, right? So now, so it is actually like going. So now all three wheels are rotating, but this wheel is actually like, because I said 60, so this become 180. So this doesn't have anything, right? So that's why it is actually like getting zero. So now if I give 30, then it is probably different. So now these two wheels supposed to have opposite and equal speed. That is what we can actually like obtain, right? So I'll just show that. So like probably I'll just try to show that. Okay, so I'll just, you can see, right? So now the second wheel is actually like become zero, and first and three is actually like equivalent opposite, right? Speed. So like that we can actually like keep doing it. So I'll just try to plot that also. So figure and plot, so T comma omega. Okay, just I'll just give you, there are several combinations, right? So now I'm giving only like a 30-degree starting. So now you can see. So you can see like now all three wheels are actually like functioning, and you can actually like see the vehicle is actually like orient, right? So like that. So now you can see like these two are not zero, but it is actually like equal and opposite, and this is supposed to be composite, right? So like that you can actually like do it. So now you can easily cross-check whatever the case. For example, now I'm increasing the wheel radius is 1.15. So now you can see like the wheel length would be changed, and this I'm consider as actually like you can see the width would be getting changed at all, right? So that way you can see, right? The width is actually like increased, and the length of the thing also like increased, right? So like that you can actually like get it. So now this is one way how to change the parameter. And now, so even I can actually like make it what you call the thing and stuff straight line. So you can actually like go with what you call circular trajectory. So here I have make it a circular trajectory in such a way that it is not circular, because radius in x-axis is 2 meter and y-axis is 1 meter. In the sense it would be give a ellipse. So you can see that. So now you can see, right? So now this is actually like a way we can actually like look at it. Okay. So like that we can actually like keep going. And here I've given the orientation is actually like match with this, but you can actually like go ahead. This is the orientation, or you can say wheel angular velocities. And now even if I actually like make it this is zero desired, in the sense the orientation is actually like not there, vehicle will go like this. So we can actually like see that how it happens. Sorry. So you can see zero orientation, but the vehicle is actually like moving on the elliptical profile and all, right? So now even actually like you can see it can be a circular. So you can actually like take it. It is a circular. Probably I say that it is 1 meter, and this is, I say that this is faster. Okay. So now I'm just trying to see. So you can see, right? So it is actually like trying to follow. Right. So now you can see like it is trying to follow a circular profile, and you can see all three are actually like trying to go in continuous manner. So now if I actually like make even the orientation should be aligned with the line of sight. So now you can actually like see this try to orient the vehicle on the trajectory which is ahead of this, so then you can actually like see it, right? So these all can be varied, and these are the different iterations we can do. And the same thing, you can actually like try to do it in Octave or Scilab and all. It need not to be only MATLAB. You can do it everything, because here we have not used any specific thing. Okay. So further, what we can actually like do it. So we can actually like modified different cases. So here we have seen like, so here I have given 90% efficiency. Even you can change this, and the radius we have already seen how to change. And even if you assume that L1, L2, L3 are different, so then also you can actually like do it. So all those things I can actually like try to do it. For example, I'm trying to show this. Okay. So, but straight away I cannot do, because I have to change L1, L2, L3 and all. So here if I change, that will change only the parameter, but it won't show in the vehicle. So that probably we can do it later. So now we will go with the triangular trajectory, which was asked one of you. So I'll just keep it the same 30 degree and other thing. So this is a dynamic model, because I just want to show. So here, if you want to change the parameter, what are the parameter for the vehicle? You can say physical parameter. So since it is in a planar, so the mass and the centroid, or you can say second moment of inertia about Z axis are the concern. These you can change based on the real one. And the wheel configuration you can change from, you can say this. And further, you can change the wheel, you can say center to the distance that L you can change. And the wheel radius you can change, wheel width you can change. And the frictional components you can change. That's all you can change, that you can actually like modify. And now even further, initial condition, you assume that the vehicle is already moving, or the vehicle is already standby in some other location, that you can give it. And we assume that it is actually like a two wire point. So in the sense, wire point time at wire point one and two supposed to be. So here I have assumed that it is equal. So in the sense, 0 to TS, I have, you can say, separate into three segment. So 0 to TS/3 is the first segment, then TS/3 to 2TS/3 is second segment. And from here to this, the third segment. And this is the initial X desired, and this is the initial Y desired, and this is the final, because we are trying to draw a triangle, that to like equilateral triangle. So it would be like this. So two is the side of the triangle. So we made it, and we can actually like give all the initial point, all velocities are zero, both via point velocity and initial and final velocity are zero. Then we can actually like go with trajectory point with via point velocity specified, in the sense all zero. In the sense, three segments will come. And this is the three segment separation, which we have seen already in another video. And so this is a dynamic model. So if you want to change, so these all can be changed. Okay. So, and we have used a simple computer torque control. So where KP and KD as 4 equal. So even you can change that little higher or lower, that according to you. And here also I have incorporated the vehicle configuration. So in the sense, I have calculated the force, individual wheel force. So that is 95% efficiency, and it is also first order dynamics. So the time delay is actually like 1 second. If you give, it won't give immediately that. It takes at least 1 second to reach that, which is saturation limit. It's like a first order aerodynamics or first order dynamics. So after that we go, and the vehicle simulation, whatever we have drawn earlier, the same thing we are trying to do. So first I will show the triangular profile. So then we can actually like go across. So this is with zero initial and final velocity. Then you can see like three segment will come. So here I did not make it a rotation. So in the sense, the green patch is standby, just to show that it is omnidirection. If you want to move also, you can do it. But I did not do that. But you can actually like make it that is actually like rotating. That is not a problem for us. So this is the case you can see. So each segment, it is actually like changing and doing it, right? So you can see here we have given the line of sight concept. So that's why the vehicle also orienting. But if you don't want the vehicle orientation, we can actually like make it that zero. So that you can actually like make it zero by putting it here. So I'm just putting it, sorry. So I'm just putting it that is zero. So in the sense, you can see vehicle go in a triangular manner that to like some of you asked equilateral triangle. So you can see, so this is the way, right? So each segment we consider as a cubic polynomial. It need not to be, even you can take a cycloidal or you can take higher order polynomial, but we have taken a simple cubic polynomial. Okay, so now you can see that the vehicle orientation is not changing. In order to show the vehicle orientation, we have shown like a two dot with red line that is going to show the x-axis. So the x-axis is not changing anywhere, right? So this is one such case. So now we'll actually like see the other way around. So with wire point velocity not specified, in the sense it is considered as a single. So for that, we have used the same code which we have done earlier. So with no wire point velocity specified, in the sense it would be a smooth, we can try to see that. You can see, right? So these are the three wire point and it is actually like, these are the two wire point and this is the initial and final point. So it is actually like trying to make, you can see it is very smooth. Okay. It is actually like very good, right? So even the differential wheel robot can follow this, right? That is the most important thing which we were actually like interested here. So that is happening even in this case. But here we have taken for omnidirectional, so it can be followed. In the sense, zero orientation also followed even with the smooth profile. Okay, so that all we can do it. So I hope you are actually like clear how we can change the individual parameter in the simulation and modify everything. So for example, even some of you asked, so how we can do this. So for example, I assume that this is 1/4. So the first segment is shorter, the second segment larger, and third segment is relatively okay. So now you can actually like see, it won't actually like make a difference. So it would be faster, the first segment compared to the earlier that you can see. And even the path, you can see curve also reduced, right? And then it is actually like going the second one also different, right? So it is actually like, you can see the profile has changed, right? So this is the way we can change even the, you can say time value of the trajectory. So these kind of variations you can always do. So with that, I'm closing this particular video. I hope you are actually like uptime. So again, you can see like these all lecture contents are available in NPTEL course. So you can actually like go to Wheeled Mobile Robot and then you can find it. And this trajectory generation all can be found from Mechanics and Control of Robotic Manipulator. And if you want to see the code also like available in the lecture contents. So otherwise you can actually like see the concept and you can draw or you can write your own. And this is the cubic with no wire point velocity. So now we have 2.2 wire points. So in the sense three segment, it is actually like 12 by 2 as the A matrix. And this is actually like 12 by 1. Okay. And this is actually like with wire point velocity specified, in the sense, again, it's 12 by 12, but it is a block diagonal. You can say thing that you can actually like see. So A is actually like block diagonal like that. You can actually like make it. Okay. So now this is the way we can actually like do it. I hope you are actually like understood the required thing and whatever the concern you raised, I hope it is actually like clear to you. So with that, I'm closing this particular video and see you then with another video set, if anything. Otherwise, thank you. See you then. Bye-bye.